شيخنا سائل يسأل ويقول: ما حكم المولد النبوي ومواليد غيره من الناس؟
يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم: عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي، تمسكوا بها وعضوا عليها بالنواجذ، وإياكم ومحدثات البدع، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ويقول صلى الله عليه وسلم: من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. والاحتفال بالمولد النبوي هذا بدعة من البدع، لأن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يفعله ولم يأمر به، وكذلك خلفاؤه أبو بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، فما فيهم وهم من أحب الناس إليه، ومع ذلك لم يفعله أحد منهم. وهكذا عصر الصحابة رضي الله عنهم، فهذا إجماع على تركه، وهكذا إجماع التابعين. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: خير الناس قرني، ثم الذين يلونهم، ثم الذين يلونهم. قال الراوي: فلا أدري أذكر بعد قرنه قرنين أو ثلاثة. والشخص الذي يدعي محبة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يطيعه فيما أمر، ويجتنب ما نهى عنه وزجر، ويصدقه فيما أخبر به عن الله جل وعلا، ويتبع سنته في أقواله وفي أفعاله وفي تقريراته. هذه هي المحبة الصادقة للرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا هو الجواب عن هذا السؤال.
And the Shaykh Hafidhullah Ta'ala was asked a question: Oh Shaykh, what is the ruling of celebrating the birthday of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Al-Mawlid, Al-Nabawi? So the Shaykh Hafidhullah Ta'ala said, Allah's Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, adhere to my sunnah and to the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa who come after me. Adhere to it, cling to it with your molar teeth, and beware of newly introduced matters. For every newly introduced matter is an innovation, and every innovation is a going astray, and every going astray is in the fire. And Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever introduces into this affair of ours that which is not from it, then it will be rejected. So celebrating the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a bid'ah, an innovation, because the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not do it, and he did not command that it should be done. And likewise, the khulafa who came after him did not do so. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and Umar radiallahu anhu and Uthman radiallahu anhu and Ali radiallahu anhu did not practice it, and they were the most beloved of people to him. They did not do it. Neither did anyone from the companions or the tabi'een perform it. So this is ijma', consensus from them, the companions, and from the tabi'een, consensus, ijma', upon not performing it. And likewise, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about these people that the best of the people is my generation, then the generation which follows it, then the generation which follows it. The narrator said, I do not know whether he mentioned two generations or three generations. So the person who claims that he loves the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then it's upon him to justify his claim by obeying him with regard to whatever he commands, and avoiding whatever he prohibits, and believing him in whatever he informs of from that which he brought from Allah, and in following his sunnah, in following his sayings, and his actions and his approvals. This is the sunnah. And this is the response to that question.